What if what went down here ended up here? It might sound kind of gross at first, but it's one of the most innovative ideas in water supply. And it's totally safe. But a skeptical public has doomed the idea pretty much everywhere it's been tried. Except for El Paso, Texas. El Paso is poised to become the first major city in the United States to build a completely closed-loop system. Wastewater will be cleaned at a treatment plant, be put through an advanced purification process, and go right back into the water supply.
The wastewater that we treat, it's residential wastewater that folks flush down the toilet, goes down the sink, and it also treats the water from our industrial customers.
I'll take this time to say, do not flush wipes of any sort down the drain or down the toilet, please.
The water we're going to produce out of the advanced water purification plant is the safest water that could be produced through treatment processes nowadays.
It's a bold step. But faced with persistent drought, they believe it's necessary to make sure that every time you turn on the tap, drinkable water comes out. This is Just Might Work, a show about surprising solutions to our biggest problems.
There's always been what would be considered massive drought here in this region. El Paso is considered high desert. We average 9 inches a year of rainfall, so it's very much an arid environment. It's dry.
According to the World Health Organization, around 55 million people are affected by drought every year. In periods of drought, groundwater sources aren't being adequately replenished. This can lead to a water crisis where communities are forced into rationing or energy-intensive options like importing water. But not in El Paso. Despite persistent drought, they've kept the water running without turning to emergency measures.
We are in severe drought mode and planning mode and operation mode all the time. And that's one of the reasons why we're viewed as a model for water resources planning across the country.
While other communities have responded to crises after they occur, El Paso has worked to make sure a supply crisis never happens. This started with an aggressive campaign to reduce use, including paying customers to replace water-intensive landscaping. Over the last 30 years, water use in El Paso has been cut by 35%. They've also built the largest inland desalination plant in the world to treat brackish water in its aquifer. So, with an eye toward the future, they're turning to one of the most controversial ideas in water supply, a completely closed loop. The technical term for the process is direct potable reuse, but in El Paso, the program is dubbed advanced water purification. The full process begins at one of their existing wastewater treatment plants.
The Fred Hervey Water Reclamation Plant is two plants in one. It's a wastewater treatment plant, and then there's the water treatment plant on the other side.
The steps at the conventional treatment plant are long-established practices. Solid waste is filtered out and settles to the bottom in huge tanks. The water is further treated by biological organisms that feed on the waste and convert it into carbon dioxide. Then, chlorine disinfects the water to kill viruses and pathogens. And this is what would be used for irrigation or released back into the aquifer. But soon, that will go directly to El Paso's facility for advanced purification for three additional layers of treatment.
The advanced water purification plant, what it does is it's gonna use what's known in the industry as full advanced treatment. Reverse osmosis membranes are best known for salt removal, but along with that, because of the pressure that's used, the membranes that are used, we remove a lot of contaminants. We're gonna use ultraviolet light with the addition of hydrogen peroxide to enhance the disinfection properties of the ultraviolet light. After the ultraviolet light is granular activated carbon. Granular activated carbon has been proven to be one of the most effective ways to treat water to remove organics.
The advanced purification plant will also have safety protocols above and beyond what is required by the books. Traditional safety monitoring is point in time, where samples are taken at certain intervals and tested for quality. But the El Paso plant will have real-time, constant quality monitoring.
So we'll be able to see trends constantly of the water quality, different parameters all the time so that we can make decisions on how to correct that before it gets anywhere near a water quality level that is gonna be unacceptable. We're gonna produce about 8 million gallons of this water for our customers per day, which represents about 6% of the total water that could be in our system at any point in time.
While a closed-loop system has been floated in other cities, public perception has consistently torpedoed any attempt to implement it. But El Paso's long history of innovation to secure their water supply under extreme circumstances has built an unprecedented level of trust in the community. a level that has led to almost universal support of the advanced purification plant.
We do our project out of diversification, not desperation. We have 100 million gallons of wastewater that flow to our facilities every day. And this is true for facilities all over the country. I think that once we show that we can treat this water reliably and safely and reuse it directly to our customers, it's gonna open a lot more doors for us to do this at our other wastewater treatment plants and our water reclamation facilities. We owe it to our customers to be efficient with every drop of water that we have, and advanced water purification is gonna allow us to do that.
Thanks for watching this episode of Just Might Work. Subscribe to Freethink as we explore the solutions that could solve our most pressing challenges.